Good afternoon everyone. Welcome all for special distance learning seminar. Today's topic is Inventory Management System version 2. And today's speaker is Dr. Manish K. Bamrutia. He is currently working as Program Officer for ART in CST Division, NACO. He obtained MBBS from BJ Medical College, Ahmedabad and Fellowship in HIV Medicine from School of Tropical Medicine, Kolkata. He worked as medical officer at ART Center Meghasena in Gujarat for 3 years and in Infectious Disease and Tropical Medicine Clinic, Ahmedabad, Gujarat for 1 year. He also worked as regional coordinator for 2.5 years under NACO for Rajasthan and Bihar State. So thank you so much for taking the session, sir. I'm handing over now to Dr. Manish Pam.
Thank you, Sudarshan. Good afternoon, everyone, from all ART centers. Welcome to this special distance learning seminar on Inventory Management System version 2. So I'll request all ART centers to ensure that data managers, pharmacists, staff nurse, and lab technician, these 4 person of ART centers must attend this seminar to be more clearer on the upgraded version of inventory management system, because these will be the patients who will be these will be the staff who will be primarily active users in IMS version 2. So as you are well aware that we have already rolled out our inventory management system, and most of the centers are now using it on regular basis. Now based on the feedback from users, this software has been upgraded to more suit to the needs of ART centers. All those issues that were multiple time coming, like link centers, PEP, transit patients, so everything has been, most of those things has been covered in version 2. So we will be discussing today basically the inventory management system and its upgraded version 2, which will be very soon, most probably in next week will be launched, and all centers will need to work on that. So it has basically the changes are it will be very similar to whatever you are using actually, but there will be additional features. It has upgraded many functionalities, so there will be data security, and we'll go through all the modules and what each ART center staff role is in this IMS version 2. So like there are 4 types of active users in IMS version 2, which primarily it will be pharmacist, and in absence of pharmacist, as you already are aware, as per our guideline, if pharmacist is not present, staff nurse will dispense. The same thing that if pharmacist is absent, post is vacant, or then the staff nurse has to do dispensation through inventory management system. So pharmacist will be basically responsible for inventory accuracy, then dispensation and all that part. Data manager will be then the next user, which will include, which will be responsible for patient record accuracy and will be entering patient's profile. Then additional one thing which we have missing in this slide is lab technician. So lab technician, so this is a new feature. Now inventory management system will also record CD4 test and CD4 inventory as well. So user ID for link lab technician is also created, and in addition LAC dispensation can also occur through this IMS version 2. So an ID of LAC staff nurse can also be created, and so basically we will have 4 type of active users. So this will be ART center pharmacist, ART center data manager, ART center lab technician, and staff nurse of link ART centers. Now report viewers will be medical officer and counselor, and approving authority will remain as such, like sex admin, sex store, and sex report viewer at that can be RC or PD at sex level. So like we'll discuss in briefly the roles and responsibility. So pharmacist will create ART users. That is, pharmacist will be responsible for creating user IDs for data managers, medical officers and lab technicians. Pharmacist will receive inventory, will relocate inventory whenever there are approval from SACs or regional coordinators. Then stock adjustments if required any in cases of expired or missing or damaged drugs. So stock adjustments can be done by pharmacist. Dispensation including transit as well as PEP. We will be in detail discussing transit and PEP patients later on. Then remaining pills during dispensation. So these are the balance pill whichever patient comes back with, that these pills will be entered so that we can the adherence can be calculated for that person. Pharmacist will also create link ART centers ID and also can record LSE consumption in a bulk if LSE is not using IMS due to any reason. Then responsibility of data manager will be register new patients. So in IMS, so data manager has the responsibility of registering all new registrations during that particular day in IMS version 2 also. So it is just one pager format. We will discuss again it. These are very basic information which we are already capturing in white card. So data manager will be responsible for digitalizing this information in IMS version 2. This is required because these patients whenever will be dispensed drugs or will be tested for CD4, so record will be available to pharmacist and lab technician. So it is very important that all new registration of that particular day should be included or should be entered in IMS software. Then patient records needs to be updated whenever there are changes in white card, because we are all these things, address, mobile, these may change in many patients, like mobile number frequently get changed, and in cases of migrants and transfers patients address also get changed. So all these things whenever required, data manager will update all these from white card. The last important thing will be link out patients and transfer in and transfer out patients. So this how to do that we will discuss in detail, but this responsibility is again with data manager to enter link out patients. Like it is a status that selection will be done on profile page of patient and transfer, the process we will discuss later on. So these are the data manager's roles and responsibilities. Now this is a new feature which is lab technician, because we will be monitoring CD4 results as well as CD4 inventory through IMS. So it is quite similar to pharmacist in terms of receiving, relocating and consumption, but it is not as detailed as like this as pharmacist module. So we'll again discuss it whenever we discuss this module, but these are the points which are responsibility of lab technician, that is receive lab inventory, relocate lab inventory obviously with approval of higher authority, then consumption, test samples of patients has to be collected and recorded in IMS, because you may refer samples to another lab, so that also is taken care of in IMS. And then most important is recording the test results. So this can be done by the LT of center which is collecting report, as well as the if there is linkages is provided, CD4 lab is not present at that center, then that center which performing CD4 test can also be do this entry. So we'll discuss pharmacist module first, and it is request to all pharmacists that please be attentive. And so very soon, most probably on Monday, you will be using this module. So I'll give you details of test version. So I'll request all pharmacists, data managers and lab technician to before in this week only to test that module. Many of you have been already trained on this IMS version 2. So I think many of you will be aware of this, but those who have not logged in till date, I'll strongly recommend that you please log in to that test version and try your hands on IMS version 2. This will be receiving, we'll discuss, this will be the options for pharmacists, like this kind of options will be there for pharmacists. And we'll discuss first with relocations or receiving. So it is simplified. There is no surplus receiving is not possible. If someone has given you 100 tablets only, then you cannot receive more than 100. So this is a feature, this is a check added. Then there is unique product batch wise expiry combination. So we have what we have seen in our prior experiences that people also are also creating newer batches, and so whenever we tend to see expiry wise details of inventory, it is very difficult to see this. So now you cannot enter batch or expiry combination, you have to select it from whatever available available options. So you cannot create new batches or expiry combinations. And the one is very important feature is added, that is goods in transit tracking and reconciliation. So whenever, so it is also whenever relocations or transfers occurring from one center to other or from SACS warehouse to ART centers, it is observed that many times like this stock is not reflected in any of the reports. So IMS is enabled now to track goods and transit also and reconciliation wherever there is whenever there is a issue, when the quantities relocate and quantity received does not match, their reconciliation can be done, and which we will discuss later on. So this is receiving receiving part. So you can receive from supplier, you can receive from SACS warehouse, or you can receive from facility. So you are, most of your other users are already aware of this, and sender can be supplier, SACS, other ART or local procurement. So you are well aware of this all things. And if sender has not made entry, you can receive through this option, that is I do not have dispatch details. So in case the sender has not updated the consignment in IMS and still you have to receive that consignment, you can select this option. So there are three types of these receipt modes similar to IMS version 1. This is for relocation, so you can relocate to SACS or you can relocate to facility. So there are two types of things, and it will be done obviously after approval of SACS or regional coordinator. So now we'll discuss about goods in transit. So in case of mismatch in quantities, means whenever the dispatch quantity does not match the received quantity, so we need to do, whenever one's quantity has been dispatched from one center and received, so throughout that center we need to track the goods. So that is transit, goods in transit, and reconciliation will be required if the quantities don't match. So this is an example. So you can see where one example where you can see one example where the there is a GIT quantity is showing 10 tablets. So consigner and consignee is available and GIT is visible like this. So you can see what amount is still in transit. So quantity which remains pending will show as GIT quantity, and you can decide whether it is in transit still or you need reconciliation or correction for that particular thing. So reconciliation means correction of this goods in transit. So suppose one center has relocated to another 100 tablets and another due to any reason has received only 60 tablets. So there will be 40 tablets which will be showing in continuously in goods in transit. So both these facilities needs to check first. So consigner facility will check whether my dispatch details are correct. So that facility will check ki whether 100 tablets has been sent or not. In case the tablets only were sent were only 60 and 100 was by mistake entered, then there is an that consigner facility can reconcile and receive those 40 tablets. In case they are correct and they have dispatched 100 tablets while but consignee by mistake has received only 60 and by after calculation they find it ki it is 100 tablets actually, but by mistake they have entered 60, they can correct it and put it in their stock as can receive. And in case both are right and there has been some losses during transfer, then admin SACS can correct these quantity and this will be reconciliation. And goods in transit to go, you can click here to go to reconciliation. And new feature, that is this is goods in transit is very new feature added to IMS version 2. So this is reconciliation. So you can select the suitable batch to accept the GIT quantity into inventory, and you can see all the details like STN details from and dispatch details and consigner's name as well as the recipient details also and the quantity which is dispatched as well as received. So the GIT, like in this case 100 was dispatched and only 90 were received, so 10 will remain in GIT, and either of these two parties or a SACS admin can only consile this. So I'll take again, there is one question, like is there any need to re-enter the patient details and drug details in IMS 2 again, in which there is IMS 1. So I'll again in detail I'll explain it to data managers. You are well aware that we have recently collected your updated master line list, so we have a plan of migrating all those master line list in IMS version 2, so that all the patients which are there in your master line list which you have sent to NACO, you won't need to enter names of those patients. We will be also, we are validating those master line lists and all the errors will be communicated to individual ART centers, and you will be, you need to correct them in IMS version 2 before start using. So you will not need to re-enter all those patients, but yes, so all those patients who have been registered afterwards, that after that master line list record, so whatever you have sent after that, whatever has been registered, you will require to add those patient details. So again, stock adjustment, it was similar to IMS V1, so there are no major changes. So in cases of expiry or mismatch or any mistakes or missed drugs, you can use this stock adjustment report. And please be aware that this is not an usual feature, you should be only using in specific condition when there is no other alternative, like in there are very specific cases when you will be doing stock adjustment, and all stock adjustment that you do is visible to NACO as well as tax admin. So we will be again monitoring that which center is doing how many stock adjustments. So this should be last resorts, and please ensure that all the dispensation should be done through IMS version 2, and in such cases you won't require stock adjustment much. So you can select the options to select the appropriate batches to reduce some errors. So you will be you can select the quantity and you can select the batches, and you have to select an appropriate reason code also, which can be selected from here. So now this is the one of the most important slides, that is dispensation layout, and there are many additions based on the feedback that you all have given to us. This is a dashboard, so you will be in this part, you will be seeing previous visit details. Last three dispensation will be visible here, including the visit date, the product dispense, quantities and adherence of this particular patient. So then there will be a patient summary, including all these things like name, gender, age, etc. of patients, including pre-ART as well as ART number. Then there will be, in this part, there will be current visit details where you need to record product, batch, expiry, quantity and remaining pills. Then this part will show next appointment details, and this part will show biometric and proxy details. So we'll be again discussing all these in details. So like these are previous dispensation. So there is one question, is there any facility to give PEP entry? Yes, so PEP, in next few slide I'll be discussing PEP as well as the transit patient. So it has been brought to our notice that sometime it have frequently happens at medical colleges that some patient of some district is admitted in that particular medical college for a transient period and has not all transferred out and transfer in formality. So in those cases also you can dispense. So transit patients and PEP patients we will be discussing later on. There is one question also, that is how to input biometric details. So at present this is option, and we will be providing you biometric machines, so you will be able to record biometric details of per patients, and this will eventually replace our signatures that you are currently capturing in our dispensing register. So here you are seeing previous dispensing previous dispensation. So you'll be seeing visit dates of last three visits. There will be product dispensations, there remaining pill columns, adherence and dispense quantity. So please mind that this is a test version slide, so you can see like three visits are same and all other errors, but this when you are you'll start actually using, this will be the actual information that will be visible here. So you'll be having remaining pills, you'll be having the last three adherences as well as what quantity you have dispensed. Now there is one also important question, that is should we discontinue registers after IMS 2? We are all sure that we don't need register, and IMS is capable of generating all the reports and all the dispensations are captured through IMS, we can go off with registers. But for that, all ART centers of complete country needs to ensure that all dispensations, each and every patients are dispensed only and only through IMS. So for initial period you have to continue your dispensation register as well as IMS version 2 entries, but like we at national level we are very clear, if you are all the centers are able to dispense and record all the dispensation through IMS, we will think of and we will work on reducing the registers. Okay, so it is up to you that how fast you can do this and how fast we can achieve that goal. So there is one question, that sometime patients are losing tablets and coming much earlier than the due date. So there is no so everyone has to understand that the process of patient management, dispensation guidelines, nothing changes with IMS V2. It is just digitalization of your dispensing practices, and it will help you to generate many reports and will help you to analyze your data and monitor your data more correctly. So whatever, like there can be n number questions, patient comes 2 days after this and 10 days after this and with that problem, everything remains same. Whatever you are doing currently with dispensation register, you have to continue to do all those guidelines. So with IMS version 2, any guideline is not going to change. It is only that you have to record those things now in this NACO provided software so that it has many benefits, which we will discuss later on. So there will be like we have discussed these things, and then there will be patient summary with quick view of detailed patient's profile. There will be current regimen view with shortcut to update regimen also. So in case you need to update any regimen or change, you can update it through from here. So this is the column. You can go to here and click, and you can update regimen in case there is any changes in register. So transit and PEP patients will be tracked separately. We'll discuss that. So this is current visit details. So in current visit details, there are three options. So first is repeat last dispensation. So in case you want to continue this, the treatment is continued and it is the same as last visit, which is in most of our patients, this will be the scenario. So in that cases you have to just click over it, and many of the fields will be auto populated. Then another option is regimen mode dispensation. In that, you will just, the patient will be assessed one, will be given one regimen, and as per that regimen, because the advantage is that we have a fixed regimens, so based on that it can be easily, it also will save your time, and you can just, all the details will be pre-populated if you select this regimens. For example, if you selecting regimen ZLE, then automatically it will show ki you have to dispense ZL and efavirenz. So it is in simpler version I am explaining you. And last option will be prescription mode dispensation, where you can select any product whichever is. So my advice or request to all medical officers and pharmacists and everyone at ART center will be that ki try to use this prescription mode dispensation very less. So so in most of cases there will be repeat in last dispensation if there is no opportunistic infection, no side effects, or there is no changes in regimen, then you will repeat last dispensation. In case there are some changes due to any reason, you can update the regimen and do regimen board dispensations. There will be very few patients who needs a tailor-made regimen and will not be covered in our regimen mode dispensation. For only for those patients, you will use prescription mode dispensations. So there will be auto-populated products for repeat dispensation, auto-select FIFO batch with options to change. So the batch will be automatically selected based on FIFO. You obviously can overwrite it. So this IMS is not binding you anything. It will be suggesting you can accept that or you can overwrite it. Option to entering remaining pills with automatic adherence calculation. So this is a very important column. So you have to record remaining pills with the patients. Please ensure that remaining pills are mentioned here. So mostly the counselors are calculating adherence as well as mentioning those remaining pills in white card. So again, pharmacist has to record that and cross check that those remaining pills and enter these. So based on prior dispensing history and remaining pills, the adherence will be self calculated. Then there will be software will give an option of 14, like there will be three options. You can select on that, and you can have an options of dates which will also show that how many patients you have already given appointment for that particular day. So it will show you five or six options, and you can select best option based on your center's workload as well as patient's convenience. And these all are suggestions only. In case you want to do a dispensation for a period another than these three, 14, 30 or 60, you can still do that. So there is one question from Kasargod. I'll try to answer that. Sometimes, I missed that question. Yes. So as there is no drug regimen in master line list for individual patient, can we dispense medicine in IMS2 as per master line list? No, regimen won't be uploaded in IMS V2. So in first dispensation, you will be doing it. You will be assigning regimens to all patients, and as your data get builded up, you will be, this all options will be open. So in first month, yes, you will be needing to update regimen, and then you will be doing regimen mode dispensation, and afterwards it will be taking much less time because you can do repeat last dispensation or you can do repeat. There is one question from Loni. Sometime patient not coming for CD4 count and routine investigation, and we are prescribing tablets for different period. Yes, so autofilling option is not binding. You can overwrite it. If you, for some reasons, you want to give 20 days or minimum like these cases, so you can overwrite all these, and so this is not compulsory. This is only suggestions. There is one question. Does the dispensing number include the remaining pills? Dispensing number, I'm not getting this, but this remaining pills needs to be entered by pharmacist. So whenever patient comes, counselor will count the remaining pills, and whatever those pills are, so needs to be included in this. And dispensing, whenever you are dispensing, these remaining pills are not count in dispensation. So it will be different dispensation. You are not going to, like, if patient is already having 4, you won't open the bottle and remove 4 and will do 54 dispensation or something like this. So these are separate thing. Regimen, remaining pills are whatever patient coming with, and dispensing is whatever. So whenever the we'll calculate adherence in next time, obviously this complete stock will be counted, but dispensation is something different, and remaining pills are the part of previous dispensation, so it does not gets calculated again. So there is one more question, like the biometric input device will be provided or we have to prepare demand. So it will be provided by SACS. We will work out with SACS, and each center will require one, so we'll work out with State AIDS Control Society, and it will be provided accordingly. So then there is next option will be dispense to. So you have to select either dispense to patient if patient has come in person, or a proxy that is picked by someone behalf of patient. So you have to tick whatever. If patient has come, you will select patient. If patient has not come and some relative or any other person has come, then you have to select proxy or picked up on behalf of patients. And then if patient has come, you can capture the biometric of that patient, and this will be enabled when once you will be having biometric machines in place, and that is already in process. So you can see now, once your regimen modes are updated and your repeat on next month onwards, after like 1 or 2 months, in less than 5 clicks, so minimum 3 or 4 clicks, you will be able to dispense medicine to one particular patient. So it will save you a lot of time and energy. So I will again request all pharmacists to please ensure that IMS version 2 is implemented on a regular basis, and you need to have a tendency to use IMS daily and for all patients. It should not happen like for per day I am 10 patient, I am dispensing through IMS, and other 10 I am dispensing through register. It should not happen. So there is one question, is there any provision of recording any other person's fingerprint rather than patient's? Yes, you can record. You can record, but you have to tick who's whether it is patient or patient is not standing personally due to some reasons. Can we hand over drugs to relocations? What will happen about biometric? So if so, relocations, no, I think you mean relatives. So obviously that is what we are doing. If patient is not coming you are giving to the representative sent by patient, that may be wife, husband or some relatives, that you are already doing and that will continue in IMS version 2, but you have to record that this for this particular patient you are giving it to patient or proxy. When will biometric card or thumb impression machine distribute to the patient? You will get to know very soon. Is fingerprint impression connected to Aadhaar card? No, at present it is not. So now again very important, and it is also again due to feedback from ART centers mostly. Just a minute, I will take one more question. It is patient not came, what can do, sir? How many times should we allow proxy? Whatever you are currently doing, you can. Ideally, you should not encourage a continuously proxy. If a patient is not turning up and every time you are giving it proxy, you should take steps. You may contact Vihan, you may contact CSC, you may have a home visit by them to identify the problem. Because there cannot be like no problem and patient is not coming. There has to be some problem and you need to sort out this. Yes, and so Dr. DJ is very right that proxy is not encouraged. It is like now we will be having a strict monitoring over key which center is dispensing how much proxy, and if one particular patient is almost given proxy only, then all these will be easily monitored. So this is we'll discuss so whatever questions I'm not able to take, I will ensure that answers reaches to you all. So this is transit dispensation and PEP dispensation. So transit dispensation is like, okay, so in just I forgot to mention that biometric capture will be green. Color will be changed once biometric is captured, and this is a new addition in IMS version 1. So now this is, we'll discuss transit dispensation and PEP dispensations. So transit dispensations is basically I'll to explain it to you that there is question how much tablets, and these all are operational questions like how much tablets, and there can't whatever patients required. Obviously it cannot be for 6 months or 2 months or 3 months. For whatever you are the best judge, you are there, you are assessing that. I cannot make thousands of guidelines if patient is this much ill or this much bedridden, you give this many tablets and you give this many tablets. You need to assess the patient's condition. Our top priority is to maintain the adherence of the patient, to maintain the supply of ARV to that particular patient who is registered anywhere in our program and is taking some, due to some problem, is lending up to your center. So you should be very empathetical to that patient and should try to help. So that it depends on patient to patient's condition, but obviously that transit dispensation cannot be for 2, 3, 4, 5 months. Okay, then you need to do transfer outs and transfer ins. So transit dispensations, so these are the patients who are registered elsewhere but are not transferred into your center, but due to any reason, which may be medical or sometime migrant patient, due to some festive reasons or due to some natural calamities, are traveling to some other places and got stuck up. So you may dispense drugs to those patients and with all these information. So there will be patient name, date of birth, gender, what drug you are dispensing, these all things will be similar to that, and product name and biometric will be in addition to this. We will add the parent ART center's number as well as name, number and pre-ART number of that particular patient in that, so that information can be snatched out. Then second option, so I think all of you are now clear about transit patients. In case you are still having any confusions, you can write it to us. Then there will be another option of PEP patient. So again, you can select here PEP dispensation, and the options will be in sync to PEP register, which we NACO prescribed format we already have. So there will be PEP dispensation in all the details which we are capturing currently in our PEP dispensation register, will like name, exposure, number of tablets prescribed, basic investigation, all the things will be covered here, and all this will be showing in your, will be deducting from all these dispensation will be deducted from your stocks. So there are few questions, I'll try to answer few. So some patients don't know the date of, we have tell the approximately, yes, okay, this option is already sorted out, and when you'll see that what is happening to date of birth, whenever there is no date of birth, you just give, you definitely will be having date of registration and age as on registration. So rough date of birth or rough age, dynamic age can be calculated based on all data managers should try to elicit information regarding date of birth, but in case they are not having it, you can write, you can just mention age at registration as well as date of registration, which you anyhow, but you need to encourage patient to come back with date of birth, okay, in case they are having. So now another module will be link ART. So here these are the key features which I'll request all data managers to pay attention to and pass this message to your link ART centers as well. So I think there are some audio problems in few of the centers. I think please follow instructions given by iTech team. So like there is only ART can create dependent link ART centers or link ART centers. So pharmacist will be the person who will be creating the ID or particular account for link ART center. So whenever you start using IMS version 2, you will create IDs for all your link ART centers. So link ART will have its own login and user. Parent ART can perform dispensation and stock consumption against LAC stock and patient. So like there are, it is, we all know that it won't be possible us to roll out to link ART centers immediately because there are many issues of internet connectivity, staff not being there, computers not being there. So I will move forward slowly. So if we have a we have a link center, if you have a link center with all the infrastructures like computers, everything, internet connection, which ICTC is supposed to have, okay, so and a staff nurse also, which in case of link ART plus centers you will be having, so you can that for staff nurse can also dispense, but in case it is not possible, whatever you are doing right now can be done. You can have at the end of the month, you can have total stock consumption of link ART center, and you can add this to in IMS version 2 under that LAC as a bulk consumption together. So this will be done, and this we also discuss. All patient assigned to LAC still belong to ART, so guidelines does not change, it will be same. All inventory assigned to LAC still belongs to ART, and it is ART responsibility to monitor that stock for expiry, availability, etc. And LAC patients can be found out through reports, and LFU and missed appointments is not applicable. So for LAC patients, so whenever, so there is so it is data manager's work to assign or link that patient to particular LAC, and once you link that particular patient, so that patient will be taking medicines at LAC, and his or her status will not be auto updated as missed or LFU. So in case those patients status change, data manager needs to change it manually. So in receive module, there have no options for receiving goods without dispatch detail. There has been, I have particularly shown you that there is an option, I do not have any dispatch details. You can click there and you will be having option to receive such goods. Okay, I'll circulate these slides and you go back and see all these things. So there is one question that, sir, will you please provide the system for pharmacists? Please This is requested to all sects. Yes, all pharmacists will be provided separate systems and internet connection. Letter from NACO has already been sent to states, and due to some there are local problems or local procedures which are taking time, and eventually all pharmacists will be having a separate system for. So there is one question: is there any option to add death, transfer in or transfer out? Yes, there is. We will discuss it in data managers module. Okay, so you can assign stock. So you can select from product lists. You can assign particular stock to LAC. There can be patients list, you can search for particular patient, and from dispensation you can do dispensations or bulk consumptions recording for that particular LACs. Okay, so all these things will open up, and like this you can choose products and whatever quantity you are assigning to. And like here you will be having product, so current stock consumption and everything you can enter. If you have a bulk consumption, you can select this stock consumption and you can add to it. So assigning patient, this will be done by data managers. So in patient profile there will be an option of link out, so you have to select yes or no. It can be edited anytime. So whenever patient link back, you can say no, otherwise you will link, and once you say yes, it will ask for name of that particular link ERT centers. Okay, and now you can for patients you can search for that patient's particular patient, and then you can assign this particular patient to LAC. So there are two options. So we'll discuss now briefly in data managers module. So there are patient details, ART details, CD4 details and linked out and transferred out details which needs to be updated in IMS version 2 by data managers. So all these new data points like CD4 trends and this has been added, and in here basically to capture LAC and transferred out details, this things has been included. So this is the field, and I know ki the slides are small, and many of you are not able to properly visualize the thing. So I'll give you test version, and it is requested that all of the ART staff in 1 or 2 days log in to that particular test version and see all these pages. So there is one question like, will there be a separate training for pharmacist and data entry operator on IMS2 before starting? Like, we have already trained 80 master trainers, and state are supposed to do ground training. Now we are almost, so this is the kind of training for you. I request Lucknow and all those centers to contact their SACS official and get a list of master trainers. So in case you have any problems, you can contact them for all these. But yes, trainings will be eventually done for all ART centers by State AIDS Control Society, but the rolling out will be most probably in next week only. So I don't think before that every center will be again able to do a training. So LFU status will be auto updated based on the dispensation. Other status like on ART, pre ART, death and opted out needs to be updated by pharmacist, data manager. Patient migration and transfer in and transfer out needs to be done by a data manager. Track additional data like regimen, registration date need to be added. From master line list, what we have calculated, we have collected, will be one time adding. So all those information which is already there in your master line list will be updated in this page. However, whatever information is missing from your master line list, you need to update that in IMS version 2. So link ART patients tracking as well as linking and assigning, all this will be done by through here. And CD4 details or viral load testing details like baseline count, date of last CD4 count and CD4 count last. So what those centers which have already provided us the updated master line list will be already having this, but in case your master line list was not updated, which will be communicated to you, you need to update all these things. So this is like transfer in and transfer out process. So again, I'm clearly mentioning that the process of transfer out and transfer in does not change. So all the documentation which are required when you transfer out patient are still required, but in addition you have to document it in IMS version 2. So for particular patient there, so you will search that patient, open the page, and there will be an option of transfer. So whenever you say yes transfer, yes, then is transfer, so yes or no there will, whenever you say yes, so it will ask you an option of which state, which district and which facility. It will be a drop down menu and you have to select from that drop down menu. So there is one question, patients are not coming for ART treatment and only for CD. So you have to record CD4 as well as dispensation, everything. So whether patient is in pre-ART care or ART care, whether assessing ART, whenever they are dispensing ART, you will record it through pharmacist. If that patient is only for CD4, you will record it through lab technician. So there is no query on that. So there will be three options and it will be drop down menu. This will be an line list, the list of patient will be appear like this. So this particular patient will be shown as transferred and you can see like this patient is transferred. And so once patient is transferred out, you will the data manager then and then will update the profile of that patient and put all these details in. Now whenever that patient reaches to another center, that center will search for that particular patient. He can see a list of patients which were transferred out from that particular center and he can accept that patient. Now it is not compulsory that patient, like for example this patient said ki he wants to go to ART center 02, but it is not necessary. In few cases patient may land up in some other ART center also. So in that cases also the receiving ART center can accept that patient even if that particular patient was not transferred to that center. But once the patient is accepted, the patient's name from the transferred list will be deducted and no other facility will be able to transfer that patient. So in case you are receiving a patient whose details are not entered in IMS, then you have to request that center first to update their IMS then and then, and then easily you can update that patient's. So status, okay. So next will be lab technician module. So there are I'll request all pharmacists, because they are using this system since 6 months, they are more trained on it, and most of the lab technician features are very similar to or even simpler than pharmacist module. And so I will request all pharmacists, so please help your lab technicians, help orient him to login processes, orient him to searching patient processes and everything. And then so now I request lab technician to pay full attention to this, because this is a newer thing and you need to enter it and you need to work on this and from next week onwards. So there is only two steps that needs 15 to 20 minutes per day. So it is not so lab technician will not provide lab technician a dedicated computer. So lab technician will only require 15 to 20 minutes or we'll say 30 to 45 minutes in high loaded center. So no separate computer is required. You can work through data manager's computer or any other computer available at center. You won't require any separate computers. So it automatically tracks CD4 due date and generates CD4 expected patients reports and miss appointments report. So due date will be auto generated if you start. Automatically track CD4, online CD4 results, on-run CD4 results will be recorded and can be entered by nodal AIRT center or feeder AIRT center. So the primary responsibility of entering CD4 results lies with the center which has collected the sample. In case at some, but there is also a possibility of nodal AIRT center entering the report, but however this is very clear that whosoever is the lab technician of that particular AIRT center needs to enter CD4 results or record that. So results updated, results will be updated instantly on patient's profile and it can be viewed by medical officer. So what the current problem we are facing is many patients are having declining trends or stable trends or CD4 and somehow they are missed during monitoring or are come to notice of medical officer after 1 month. So this is a unique feature just added to ensure better patients monitoring. So you will be able to see all the serial CD4 counts of one particular patient. So it will be very helpful and that's why I'll request all lab technicians to record all their CD4s and viral load once it happens in IMS only. So this is the process. Lab technician will search the patient's name. He can click on search. So then test type. Now at present we are doing CD4 tests only. Viral load option is kept because we'll be rolling out viral load testing in future. So you will be clicking on CD4 test and you can add that particular patient for list of so you can click on this add and this patient will be added to the list of all those samples you are sending to testing. So then you will click, then LT needs to click on. So I just a minute, there are few questions. So there is questions like we don't receive any problem in editing patient's details, that there is no option of editing in this. Just a minute. Regarding training of AIRT staff, regarding IMS version 2, only 3% are trained by NACO. Respected sir, so you were expected to down train all the remaining pharmacists. So we have trained master trainers and we have identified master trainers based on nomination from joint directors and regional coordinators, and we have identified one person per 8 or 6 or 8 centers. So yes, so that has to be done. Next question is, data manager is facing problem in editing patient details as there is no option for editing in his or her user login. He has to depend on pharma. We will think on that, we'll consider this and we'll come let you know about all these things changed. A letter should be sent from NACO. Okay sir, we will send. So there is one question is, how to differentiate FIAIRT CID with nodal AIRT ID in IMS. So every AIRT center is going to have one unique name and ID. So there is no question of, for FI is a, functionally it is an AIRT center. These are operational reasons for which we are calling them as facility integrated, but all the functionally they are AIRT centers and you need to consider them as AIRT centers only. So there will be a list and when you click send for testing, this may be your own center or the center, nodal center for from where you will be linked to. So now record results, that can be done, that has to be done by lab technician. So all the list that has been created in this page will be available to the testing site also, and all these things where they can add all these things to like pre-IT number and all these things will be there, and current test counts and date of test counts will be updated here, and next appointment date will be auto calculated, but you can change it. It will be based on logic of 6 monthly CD4 testing, but you can modify it if required. Okay, so now consumption is not live, it is not it is end of the day record stock consumption. So as you are doing in registers, you have to do it here. You have product name will be there, you have to write current stock, goods in transit, and you'll you have to give stock consumption or stock adjustments. So it will be very simple. You will click here and you can consume a bulk. For example, if you have you have consumed 120 tests per that day, you can write it 20. So it is not a lifetime or this thing. You can do it very easily on end of the day. So dashboards and report generations, we are already working on it, and there will be improved reporting engine, and report generation will be much more helpful. So you will be getting, so don't worry about this. As far as we are capturing all the data, reports will be fine, and most of the reports will be generated eventually, and we are currently working on that. This all you know, there are some newer reports which we are trying to figure out, and so all these things will also be available in IMS version 2, and analysis will also be possible. So this is most important. Now I'll request all data managers, pharmacists and lab technicians to write this thing. So that is URL for test.imsnaco.in. So I request all those who are attending this session to log into this site. Your username will be same as V1. So whatever username you are using as V1 will be same thing, and password will be admin. This is only for training purposes. So still you have some time till IMS version 2 will be launched. So I'll request all to to log into this site and make yourself familiar with all these things. So now we have already provided you one email ID, which is imsnaco.in@gmail.com. So whatever problems you are facing, you can write us to us, and we'll try to solve all the queries. In addition, I'll circulate names of master trainers of your particular state, so that you can contact. So first level of contact for anything will be your master trainers. We have identified one trainer per 8 centers, so you need to know which was your center's master trainer, and then in case your query is not resolved, you can start. And in addition, on that site only there is user manual and videos which will help you. I'll request you to go through it and make yourself familiarize, and in any case of problem, let us know. Thank you very much for letting there is one more information that this is again, please provide your attention to this. So inventory information validation. So I think some also has questioned about this, ki whenever the transition will happen, the existing inventory as on day of transition will be moved to IMS version 2. So you won't be entering your existing inventory, but you will be having an option to correct the quantity. So all the pharmacists, before moving to version 2, a mail will go to you regarding all these things, but you need to check your inventory, and this is an opportunity to correct all your mismatches in stock, in current present stock and IMS stock. So you'll be correcting all these things. And pharmacist at present will create the accounts, that is for data manager, lab technician and link ART centers. That has to be done on the day of transition, and will inform you through mail that when exact date of transition, will inform you on mail. Okay, so in case of any query, you can get back to us. Thank you very much for I have not covered few questions in last, and I'll try to answer them through email, because it
Thank you so much for valid session, sir. If any questions are unanswered, we'll send you those questions via email. Once again, thanks to Dr. Manish for his valid and valuable session.